See, whether you call it alternating current or alternating voltage, doesn't matter, the one and the same thing. Okay? What does alternating means? What does it mean? It changes, is it? So tell me, which one are the alternating voltages or alternating currents? One, A, B, C, D, which one are the alternating currents? Is it alternating?
No.
They're definitely not. Then?
That is also not.
This is yes or no? Why?
It's not changing.
Changing,
not
changing.
Yeah.
It's changing. But it is not becoming negative. It is not changing the direction. So it is not alternating. It's a direct current. Fine. These are changing the direction. There is a positive current. After some time, there is a negative current. And in our syllabus, we are specifically focusing on this kind of AC, which is sinusoidal curve. When I say sinusoidal, cos is same as sinusoidal, like sine theta plus pi by 2 is cos only. So it one and the same thing, they behave similarly, right? So we are dealing with this curve in this chapter. Why? Because this is what we are creating. In the AC generator chapter, there is a sine term coming in or not? EMF was equal to NAB omega sine omega t, right? So this is what is getting generated out of that rotating this thing. Okay, so this automatically comes naturally. Fine. So our focus is this type of voltage. See, since this is the first time you guys are learning about alternating current, so we will be first talking about the basic elements. Like for example, a basic circuit with AC, like only resistance connected to AC first, then we'll connect only inductor, then only capacitance. Okay, we'll find out the current, voltage, power in all these circuits, and then we'll talk about what if we connect them together, what will happen, how we'll find out power, current and voltage, all that. Okay, and once we are done with everything, then we'll talk about few practical stuff, like how can you utilize alternating current to create something which is, you know, like instruments which we have learned in current electricity, potentiometer, Wheatstone bridge. First we learn the basics, then instruments, similarly here. Okay, but the basic of alternating current starts from the very very basic, because you're learning alternating current for the first time. Okay, so the first circuit that we are going to study is resistance circuit. Or only R. So if you connect a resistance of value R with an AC voltage source, AC voltage source is denoted by this. This is AC and this is DC. This is AC. Okay? Let's say AC voltage source is this V naught sine omega t. Okay? First you tell me, what is the average voltage? How much is the average voltage? This is the sign for average. Like this. How much is the average voltage? This is V. So average voltage is how much? Average of sine graph is what? Zero,
yeah,
na?
Yeah, because minus
it is zero. It is equally above and equally below. Okay? So average of voltage is zero. Current is how much? If you apply Kirchhoff's this thing, you will get current is equal to V naught by R sine omega t simply. Even current also changes with time.
Yeah.
So what is the average value of current?
Zero.
So how different it is with zero voltage and zero current? There is a lot of difference, right? So average is not giving a true picture of what is happening, right? Average of zero is also zero. Fine. This is what a current which continuously changes and V naught sin omega t is voltage that is continuously changing. But if I ask you what is on an average, what is the voltage in AC, if you say 0, that doesn't make any sense. Because if you say on an average it is 0, it should not give you a feel that there is no voltage. Fine? So the way you take the average is completely different when such thing happens. What you do? You square it so that negative also become positive. You square it, then you take average of all the squares, and then you take the square root. So it becomes root mean square. Fine? So we will be taking root mean square. Root of all the means of the square. Fine? So now let us try to find out VRMS. RMS means root mean square. This will be equal to what? The mean of V square sine square omega t ka under root. Try to get the value of this. Use the fact that average of cos omega t is 0, cos 2 omega t is also 0, average of that. Use it and try to get the value. The average of V naught square is V naught square. So V naught will come out of this square root. You have to take average of sine square omega t. What is sine square omega t equals to?
1 minus
cos 2 omega t divided by 2. The average of that. Fine. Stop talking. So this will be root over average of 1 by 2 is 1 by 2. It's a constant. Minus average of cos 2 omega t divided by 2. How much is this? 0. So you will get V naught by root 2. Fine. And as a fact also you should remember, average of sine square is 1 by 2. Average of cos square is 1 by 2. Fine. Now it makes sense that okay, on an average, if you take root mean square, the voltage is V naught by root 2. So now it is different from 0. So there is something.
So what is the RMS?
Average. Nothing. VRMS is V naught by root 2. What is IRMS? I naught by root 2, which is what? V naught by
R root 2.
Fine. So we have found average of voltage and current. But this is just average. Actual current is this and actual voltage is this. Fine. Now, can you find out how much is the power dissipated in the resistance?
With respect to the RMS.
Power dissipated. What do you mean by with respect to R? How we find power?
I square R.
I square R.
V naught square by R.
2R.
2R square.
No.
Oh yeah, the V naught I naught by 2R.
V naught square R sine square omega t. This is what you'll get? Power? Isn't it? This is I. I square R is that? So power dissipating in the resistance depends on time. Okay? Fine? So we'll try to find out average power now. But you should remember one thing is if average power is coming out to be 0, you don't take RMS of the average power. Because power represents energy. Fine, it has some physical significance, right? So we don't take RMS value of power, we just take average of power. Fine. So what is average of power over here? V naught square by R into average of sine square omega t. What is the average of sine square omega t? 1 by 2, right? So this will be equal to V naught square by 2R, okay? Now, if you try to write down in terms of RMS values, you can say that it is VRMS into IRMS, or it can be written as IRMS square into R. Fine. So when you use RMS values, the formulas are very similar to what you have in direct current. Okay. So this is the first basic circuit. Now you can plot the graph also and see. In this graph, plot current, voltage and power. Done? The voltage will be simply like this. This is voltage. The current will be what? If you assume resistance to be more than 1, V0 by R will be less than V0.
So,
would
you lag behind?
No. They are both sine.
No, but the graph will be the same, but we're going to start from a different point because the difference of R.
It will be like this. If R is more than 1, when voltage is maximum, current is maximum. When voltage is 0, current is 0. What about power? Power is this. Okay? So it will go like this and it will just hop over. It will remain in the positive quadrant. Fine. This is the most simple circuit for AC. Just resistance is connected. Okay. Write down a question. A light bulb rated 1000 watt for 220 volt. I am talking about AC. Okay? When I say 220 volt and I don't say anything else, what does it mean? What voltage is this?
RMS.
RMS. Okay? Otherwise, I have to specify that this is peak value or whatever it is. If this is peak value, what will be the RMS value? This divided by root 2. Okay? You have to find out resistance of the bulb, peak voltage of the peak voltage. Okay. And IRMS. How much?
Power is average.
Yeah, power is average power. There is no meaning of RMS power. So power is given.
IRMS 4.54.
Power is IRMS square into R. This is also equal to VRMS IRMS, and that is also equal to VRMS square by R.
Power.
Resistance is 484.
What is the calculation for
R is equal to
0.454.
When you substitute values over here, you get resistance as 484 ohms. Peak voltage is how much? This RMS voltage multiplied by root 2. Because peak voltage divided by root 2 is RMS voltage. Fine, should I proceed?
0.454.
Resistance is 484. Peak voltage is 311. And current is 0.45.
So I can do, I just use 1.473 over here.
1 divided by root 2 is 0.7. 0.7. You remember that. 1 by root 2 is 0.7. Root 2 you know. And root 3 by 2 is 0.866. So these things you must be.
Root 3 by 2 is 0.866.
1.7 divided by 2. These things should be on your fingertips. You should not be like, okay, let me divide with root 2. No, multiply with 0.7. That is easier. Okay, so should we proceed?